welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. You're probably already aware that it is Mental Health Awareness Week, and it's something I'm quite passionate about. If you didn't already know, I want to be a psychotherapist and help people with poor mental health, but also having struggled myself with poor mental health, it's definitely driven that passion more to help others as well, and just how important it is to be aware of the effects of poor mental health. I'm not really going to go into my own difficulties, because that's for me. So yeah, and if you see me looking down, it's because I'm referring to my little notebook, because I don't want to make this completely hugely edited. So if you see me looking down, I'm just referring to this. I actually did my A-level art coursework on disguising depression, and on the back of my coursework piece, I wrote a piece of text that I feel sums up mental health awareness quite well. So I'll read that to you like I'm a 4-year-old in a school play. Mental health awareness to me is giving people knowledge of the well-being of the mind, and how for so many people that well-being isn't so well. The mind is very complex, and unfortunately there can be and is many complications for people for a massive range of reasons. These complications are what mental illness is, and they cause such negative effects that people can no longer live the life every human deserves, the life where you can go worry-free and feel content with everything around you. This is not their doing, and many people forget that. You can't just tell someone to snap out of it, get over it, cheer up, think differently, because it really, really, really doesn't work like that. Self-blame is one of the biggest things people feel when fighting mental illnesses, because of the lack of understanding from others. The stigma created around mental illnesses makes sufferers feel like it's their own fault and it's their doing, that they experience what they do is all down to them. The stigma needs to come to an end. It will get there, but one person can't do it alone. Today, I ask you to go and share the damaging effects that mental illness has, not just on the people who suffer, but the people around them as well. And we can make a change so that no one has to feel ashamed, and that no one goes through their battle with their mind alone. So, elaborating and explaining that a little bit, I think as good as people sharing their details of their story is good, and it shows people that they're not alone, the attention can sometimes unintentionally get focused on that particular person and their story, rather than making people aware of the damage poor mental health has on so many people's livelihoods. When I was doing my mental health first aid training, got this big old manual with it, I was shown many statistics, but these are some of them I wanted to pick out today. 676 million people are affected by mental health issues worldwide. Anxiety disorders followed by mood disorders such as depression and bipolar disorder and substance use disorders are the three most common mental health issues globally in any given year. About half of the people who develop mental health issues have the first onset by their mid-teens and three quarters by their mid-20s. Of the 20 leading causes of disability worldwide, over 5 are mental health issues. Major depression, anxiety disorders, schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, and other mental disorders and substance use disorders. Depression is the number one leading cause of disability worldwide, and I just think that's don't really have any words, to be honest. It's just awful. That really should not be the case at all. And those statistics are from previous years, never mind right now when we're in a global pandemic. We've seen a massive rise in mental health since the coronavirus outbreak, and it's going to increase even after it's over, because so many people who have lost loved ones, they can't have that closure, and they can't be by the bedside whilst their loved one is dying, and that impact is going to be long lasting, way past this coronavirus. It's not just now, it's forever. Now more than ever, we need to be more aware of people's battles with their minds. And please, if you take anything from this video, educate yourself a little bit more on mental health and how it affects others, and also talk to people. Whether you've got a mental illness or you don't, talk to people, check on people, see how they're doing, and tell people how you are feeling, and so you can support each other. It's very, very daunting to admit and reach out for help, but I really, really can't stress enough how important it is to do so. I really, really empathise with you if you're finding it extremely scary and you're extremely nervous to call the GP, but when you do, it really, really does lift a weight off your shoulders. And it's also really easy to feel like you've got no one to talk to, because you don't want to worry your loved ones, like your parents or your siblings or your closest friends. You don't want to worry them with something that's going on, and you don't want to hurt them or make it feel like it's their fault either. And it's easy to just be really scared to contact professional help as well, because you can kind of get the feeling like, oh, this is actually real now, having to get professional help. It's not anything to be ashamed of or afraid of. Again, it's a big weight off your shoulders when you do. And I think everyone would rather know than not know. I want my direct messages on Instagram to be somewhere where you can go to if you don't feel comfortable to talk to someone close to you, or you're too scared to call professional help. Come message me on Instagram and I can have a chat with you or whatever. I really want that to be a safe place for you to talk about how you feel, and I can advise you on what you can do next to help yourself. I am, like, don't be afraid to do so. I am nice, I promise. But yeah, I think that's all I have to say, to be honest. I could ramble on and on and on this topic. You know, this manual is this thick for a reason. But obviously I don't want to go on and on and on. Thank you very much for watching this video, and I hope you liked it. It really means a lot that you've watched it, more than any other video I've ever done. And please spread the awareness and look after yourselves and those around you. And that's all I have to say. I'll see you in another video.